why so much hate on a 3.6 liter V6 Pentastar engine? Why so much hate? I don't get it. But let's see why everybody hates them. Stay tuned, y'all. That might be one reason, because they sound good. Another reason could be because they're actually reliable. I've had this car since 2018, I think July, August 2018. And the only issue I've ever had, well, two issues. One is no fault to Chrysler or FCA, but the dead battery, that was the major one. Or the minor one. And the major one was when my shit went in limp mode after I got the oil change from the Dodge dealership. So, two issues out of 3 years. I guess another issue could be the fact that, and excuse the sun, another issue could be that us V6 owners, given the opportunity, given the money, the income, a little bit of networking, a little bit of researching, you can make these V6s faster than these fucking V8s. That might be a big reason. And speaking of V8, that is a SS Trailblazer. Nice V8. That's a good one. Another funny reason is, just maybe I'm kind of trolling myself here, but let me show y'all my gas mileage right now. 15.8. Another reason people hate on the V6s is clearly because of the gas prices and the gas economy. Now, granted, I've been driving mine crazy because, as you can see, it's super cold outside. We got snow. This car does great in the snow. So why not drive a little bit of wild, you know? When the weather and the conditions permit that, why not do it? So, and that's just me just fucking around, not full throttle, nothing, gas to the floor, none of that. But the gas mileage, man, like, to you V8 owners, now, first of all, let me say this. One thing is, I want a V8. I will have a V8. My ultimate car, if I'm being honest here, it's a Hellcat Charger. I don't really care for the wide body because you can easily just, you know, do that. But I am definitely getting a Hellcat when it's all said and done. But in that gas mileage, in terms of that gas mileage, and for me just playing around, I'm at 15.7. That's a terrible number for what it really is, man. I'm sitting outside my local. Well, not local because I don't live nowhere around here. But I'm going to go grab a drink. But yeah, man, gas mileage. In terms of gas mileage, you V8s, you Hellcat owners. Let me say that because I can't really say that for the baby V8s. You 5.7s and the 6.4 is like a big V8. Nah, that is a big V8. But for you Hellcat owners, oh, hell, fuck it. All of you VA guys, y'all hate putting gas in that car. Y'all fucking despise going to the gas pump. Me? It's kind of the same way, except I'm not going as nearly as much as y'all, and I'm not paying nearly as much. That might be a false statement because I'm not familiar with the gas tank sizes on the V8s. But for mine, right now, gas is like $3.70, $3.80 a gallon for 91 here in Colorado. This car takes 17 gallons. Y'all could do the math. I'll drop the total number somewhere right about here. But for you V8 owners, man, your gas. Y'all's gas is out in a couple of days. Done. Empty. Right back to the gas pump. Us V6 owners, unless we're driving like assholes in traffic, we're good for a week or 2 weeks. And that's on the same gas, presumably the same gas tank that y'all have. the drawback is that power. It's that fucking power. But let's touch on that one next. Let me get back to driving. But you V8 owners, y'all got the power, you got the engine, you got everything. When it comes to a car, you got it all. The mods for your shit is unlimited. Versus us, well, you gotta know what you're doing, know who to talk to, know where to look, and be willing to fork up money to get your car fast. It is what it is. But that's not a knock on the V6. That's a knock on the fucking auto industry as a whole, not producing enough fucking mods for the V6. But again, if you know where you're looking, you can easily do it. You can easily do it. Hell, I've done mine. I dropped the 0-60 on mine by a second and some change. I think it was 1.1, 1.2. You know, you can have fun with these, man. You can have fun with these. But, yeah. If the market or companies knew better, if they knew better, and this is literally just facts right here, the V8s are dying. Everybody is aware of that. Everybody has come to the realization that they're not forever, which means the V6s are now finna get the torch. So if companies were smart, and now granted, you got Prodigy Performance, you got RIP Superchargers, you got a few others that are producing, and I say big time mods for the V6s. But if other companies wanted to get in on this money pit, if they wanted to get in on this lottery ticket, they would start producing it. It's not that hard. Produce the parts for us. You have no choice now. One of the last things that I'll even touch on is, because we've touched on mods, we've touched on the future, we've touched on gas mileage. Another reason why people hate the V6s, man, is engine trouble. Now, granted, I've never had any issues with my engine per se. My shit has been perfect since I had the car. And I'm sorry for this color, y'all, but the sun is right there. And yeah, man. That was not a full throttle, but it's pretty nice. Pretty nice. But yeah, man, engine trouble. V6s are known for having engine troubles, man. Transmissions aren't known for lasting long. The engines themselves, aside from the transmission, aren't known for lasting long. You get a lot of miscellaneous issues, rocker arms breaking, shit like that. And it's never anything crazy that you can't fix or you can't replace or get around. But it's just, with a V6, man, people look at it like this. If I got a cheap engine and these engines are super cheap, if I got a cheap engine and something breaks, why go through the hassle to fix it when at the end of the day it's a V6? Putting out maybe 300 horsepower, maybe. Why go through that when I can just go get a V8 that's pushing out, let's say realistically, 370 on up to 707. I'm keeping it in the Dodge lane. Why do that? it's insane to do that, and I get it. But put some time and effort and money into your car. These engines are just like any other engine minus the EV bullshit. I'm not a fan of EV. Not a fan of EV. But put your time and money into these and you can get V8 results. You can get better than V8 results. It just requires you as the owner, as a driver, as the fan of the car to put money into it, put time into it. It's not going to come from the dealership, unless you're talking something outside of Dodge, Kia Stingers, EcoBoost Mustangs. Those are a little different. But in terms of FCA, listen, man, you're going to have to love your car. You're going to have to put money into your car. It is what it is. So just do it. Or jump to the dark side and get a V8. It's pretty, it's that damn simple, y'all. And I guess the last thing that I'll even give some time and energy to is the fact that the V6s, the reason, maybe this is just the one reason or the main reason, but I could be wrong about this. Let me know in the comments. But the main reason most people hate on these is because I guess they can. It might not have to be a reason at all, but just because they can, they will. That's how it go, man. If you got something better, why not talk shit about the people that's in terms of cars? If you got something better than a 6, why not sit back and say, oh, fuck the 6 because of this or because of that? I get it, man. I get it. But that might just be the reason. It might not be anything other than the fact that it's a V6. So, it is what it is, man. But just don't forget that us fucking V6 owners will dust some of y'all fucking V8s, man. And it's just going to require us to put time and money into it. And it is what it is. But just don't forget that we can do it. Don't fucking forget that. And in regards to that topic, stay tuned, man, because here soon I will be dusting some fucking VAs here in the near future. Y'all stay tuned for that. But other than that, man, I'm actually lost right now. I don't know where the fuck I'm at. I gotta park somewhere and turn on some navigation so I can get back to the spot. But yeah, man, listen, man, if y'all are new around here, subscribe and stay true around here. Don't be wasting time watching the videos if you ain't subscribed, man. I'm on the road to, I'm going to say 15K, because 15K is attainable. The grind is finna be ridiculous this year. But if y'all are not subscribed, yo, what the fuck are you doing? Go ahead and subscribe. Make it easy. It'll help me out. It'll help yourself out, because chances are you're driving the V6 and you're looking for something to do to it. So come on, man, link up, join the channel. That's network. You see what I've done, you drop comments on what you've done, and boom, man, we can make it happen. But on that note, man, I'll catch y'all again in the next video. I'm out of here. Let me get some navigation going, because I'm legit fucking lost. So yeah, catch y'all next time.